Hello, everybody. Welcome, Pike of the Year. Today, podcast, let's talk about saving. You know, like, we grow up with an economy, in a society where you can't really save. So, I asked my friend at work, and I said, do you have any saving? He said, no, they don't have any saving. They just live hand to mouth. So, first of all, because the system disincentivizes saving, right? So, if you save, the value of your saving go down, right? And I think in some places in Europe, they used to charge your account for having money there. Like, they basically charge you for your saving. Now they just raised the interest rate. They may not be able to take money now, but they used to take money from your account because the interest rate was negative. That's crazy, right? So that's a massive war on savers. It's a big war on savers. And still, the inflation rate, right, is like double digit in most countries, right? Like the real inflation rate, really double digits, right? So, and if you look at places, right, if you're having like to get like 2% inflation, the 2% of interest rate on your saving, by having to lose 10% on your inflation, that's not worth saving, right? So the society basically is running off a cliff. Saving, you can't save, right? First of all, you may not have enough to save, but even if you had enough to save, you don't have an incentive to keep your money in the bank account. So what do? Right? Some people just go there and invest, right? They try to gamble over there in the stock market. I don't even know what it is. And they just go there and just buy a bunch of stocks. Okay? So some people even go and buy a bunch of shit coins on the crypto space, all those things, right? Because they are looking for saving, right? They wanna grow their money so they escape the inflation problem. But the secret is simple. It's Bitcoin. Why? Because Bitcoin is time, right? You could never really, before Bitcoin, you could not send $1 million, right, across time and space, right? Now you can, right? Now you can. You can send any amount of money you want across time. That's incredible. Well, you could use gold, right? Gold is like the closest thing we could use, but gold still, you know, devaluated over time, right? Because you have a bunch of paper gold, you have a bunch of like gold miners digging gold out of the ground, and right. So, and also, you know, like, the gold miners, right, they're just dumping the gold in the market, right? They just mine the gold and dump it in the market. Now you say, okay, well, what about Bitcoin? Bitcoin, they miners. The miners mine like 6.2 Bitcoin every block, every 10 minutes. That's a lot of, like, money. That's like $2 million a day, approximately. Well, yes, that's true. That's for the security of the network. But over time, this will be shrink. This is at least less than 2% of inflation on the network, right? So like that's less than 2%. And also in 2024, the supply, right, it's gonna be half, right? So there's a halving. So that's what most people don't forget. There's a halving in the Bitcoin issuance, right? There's no halving in gold, right? If you discover how many golds, you just discover it, right? So there's no limit on how many gold you could find, basically. The supply may shrink, but if you put enough energy and resources, you will find enough, right? So for Bitcoin, it's not the same, right? The block entrance is the same, right? Every 10 minutes for the next, right, every 4 years, right? So there's no there's no amount of money you can spend to give you more Bitcoin. So, and also, like people say, well, what about the paper Bitcoin, right? Yes, I know, paper Bitcoin is gonna come. There are all this EDF. This is why those silly Bitcoiners talking about, oh, Bitcoin ETF, we need a Bitcoin ETF. Well, this is a big problem, because when you have a Bitcoin ETF, they're gonna shrink the Bitcoin supply. They're gonna take out all this Bitcoin demand out of the market, and they're gonna confiscate it, Bitcoins, right? They're gonna create fake Bitcoin, like paper Bitcoin. So that's what you have with WAP BTC on the Ethereum network. It's a paper Bitcoin. It's not Bitcoin. So you're gonna have that. Like, that's why I don't like those like ETF thing. I think it's fake. Right? You're gonna have. That's why you have gold price cannot go up. That's why gold price cannot go up, because there's too many paper gold. Right? So they take out the demand for gold. Because all those dummies out there, they are buying paper gold, right? So that's why you see the gold price also go up. I mean, if I want to go buy gold, I just buy the physical gold, right? There's like so many gold store. You could buy like so many paper gold, right? Or so many like physical gold, right? Why would you go buy paper gold, right? It's like extremely stupid. So anyways, this is the toxic talk for today. And it was talking about saving, right? Saving your money, right? Saving your money, that's the best thing you could do for yourself, right? So you don't want to leave. Do you want to work all your life? No, you don't want that. You don't want to, like, sacrifice all your life work for just, like, nothing, right? So you want to have some saving, something you have somewhere. Right, that can support you if you have a problem, or you got sick, or your children get sick, or, you know what I mean, you can support yourself. So anyways, and Bitcoin is the best tool to do that, right? Bitcoin is time, right? So once you have your time, right, doesn't matter how much time you put into it, to study it, to buy it, right? So you can, this time never disappear. Because Bitcoin is a closed network, right? It doesn't leak energy. So that's it right there. And also, what to put this in perspective, right? Think about it. In 2024, right? Like, you need like 3.1 Bitcoin every 10 minutes, right? So the block, right? So in 20, let's say, after 2 years, right, after 4 years again, it's gonna be 2028, right? You're gonna have 1.5 Bitcoin, right? And then in 2030, right, about 2030, you're gonna have like you're gonna have less than one Bitcoin every block, right? So people are gonna have to mine like less than one Bitcoin every block. So that's crazy, right? So, and also in 2034, It's going to be less, even less. So that's a crazy idea over there. So anyways, guys, I just arrived. I'm getting in. So this was a pie cover. It's raining crazy out there today. But yeah, I wanted to do that anyway. So I hope you guys enjoy. Now I'll see you in the next Toxic Talk.